Success in business is, to coin a phrase, not rocket science. Often it comes back to the absolute basics of just how well something works. And Apple, particularly over the last 10 years, has become one of the go-to companies for simplicity, performance and looks. And the result for the company itself has been quite astonishing. Have a look at this for a comparison. We're going to bring up an iPad and tell a few stories. Go back to July. There was a statement from the US Treasury which showed the US government had an operating cash balance of $73.8 billion. A month earlier, look at what Apple was reporting in its earnings. Cash reserves of $76.2 billion. It was taking in more than it was spending. It was more cashed up than the world's biggest economy. Have a look at what the stock price has done. We're taking a 10-year look at this. And 10 years ago, if you'd bought one single share in Apple Incorporated, it'd cost you $8.07. 10 years later, that same share is worth $404.30, which is incredible, I think, in anyone's language. What about iPads? If you bought one of those in April, May, or June of this year, the third quarter it is in the United States, yours was one of 9.25 million iPads sold in that period. And similarly, and this is an amazing number, if you look at the iPhone, in that same 3 months, if you bought one, it was one of 20.34 million units sold in just those 3 months. All those numbers, though, it's basically past success when you think about it. What we have to query at this point is whether Apple can keep up this sort of momentum in what is now a post-Steve Jobs era.
I think that Apple will, in the short term to medium term, face very little challenge. They have some tremendous, thanks to Steve Jobs, and his leadership, some tremendous and highly innovative products going forward. The question will more be 5 years out, 8 years out, will Apple be able to do the thing that Steve Jobs has done in industry after industry, you know, revolutionizing the computer industry, revolutionizing the mobile phone industry, taking on the music industry, moving into television. These are the kinds of moves that take a true visionary, and this really is to a huge extent, Steve Jobs' legacy, to be able to reinvent not only himself, but entire industries. So can Apple create a giant or be that giant moving forward? We'll have to see in the next half decade or so.
So what's the upshot here? iPads, iPhones, Mac computers, they're all nice products for sure. And Apple can talk all it wants about them using marketing phrases like magic and amazing. But in the end, it's a business, an incredibly successful one, and it has gotten there through simplicity, functionality, and, let's face it, aesthetics. Perhaps in the end, those are the lessons the business world can take from one Stephen Paul Jobs.